Would Mayfield be a good fit in South Beach?
When I saw that, that was the first thing I thought of is, you know, I'm from South Florida, and I know that a lot of guys cannot handle going to that culture. And it's not about the team, it's about the city. And I think Baker Mayfield is one of those guys. We saw, you know, he had a couple incidents in college. He's a very lively character, you know, public intoxication, running from police. A lot of people like to take that and criticize him as a draft prospect and say that he has, you know, quote unquote, off the field issues. I don't think that those things are serious if I'm drafting him for my team. I don't think he should live in Miami where there's a lot of distractions, a lot of potential to get in trouble down there. He needs to be in a city where there's not really any place for him to get in trouble. So I think he's still a good prospect when it comes to those off the field things. I don't think any team would have to worry about that unless he's in a place where there's a lot of distractions and place, you know, as mom says, like nothing good happens late at night. You don't want to kind of be out where things can happen. It's a perfect comparison to Baker.
Well, you'd rather be in Miami than Cleveland, I guess. But yes, for the reasons you stated, Cleveland makes more sense. I doubt they draft him, but it was kind of like the J.R. Smith theory when he went from New York to Cleveland because, you know, you're hanging out at Applebee's or something over there.
Right.
But when you're Baker Mayfield, I do think there are a few issues here. I don't take umbrage with any of the stuff he did on the sidelines or the gestures, except for in combination with getting in trouble off the field as well. It's not the type of thing that makes me say he can't ever get past it or I'm going to not draft him because of it, but I am a little bit concerned. You know, it's one of those, you know, you put a mark in the book to go back to it and sort of go over it before you eventually make that pick. So anytime you have that and you have Miami, it's not exactly the best combination. But when you're drafting that position in particular, especially for need, you can't overreact to something like that.
That's a good point. And I think with Baker, too, there's a lot of questions about him with his height and his, you know, other potential reasons why he may not be a good pro prospect. When you add this to that list, you know, GMs talk about checking boxes. This is another knock with those other questions that could cause him to potentially fall. But a lot of teams need quarterbacks this year, and there's nothing better than that for Baker Mayfield. So he's a position of need, and he'll definitely be picked pretty early.